so much. Oh, gosh. It's nice to be back in New York City again. really
Welcome.
So are we having too much fun yet, anybody? Thank you.
Hi, Jim.
Hi, it's nice to
How
be
are
here.
You? Is this your first time in Chattanooga? Or has it been a long time?
It's been a long time.
It's been a long time,
yeah.
Hasn't it?
Yeah, I worked on a road gang here once. That's why you have all these nice tarred streets.
What you been up to, Jim?
Diddy Boffin and Lovely Gaggin, mostly. Here with my wife and daughter and our buddy. And just having a good time. And still doing Mickey Mouse. We're on our 14th version of Mickey Mouse, Funhouse, Clubhouse, Outhouse, Something House. Always a house. House of Mouse. See? But yeah, still going. Occasional poo stuff here and there.
Yeah.
Winnie the. So we know.
Yeah. They're not a bounce, and you never know when you got to bounce.
Oh my God. Yeah, I get that a lot. Yeah, and my joke is that I'm Winnie the Pooh and I'm Tasmanian Devil, so I'm Pooh and the Anti-Pooh. Which,
there you go.
Yeah, and just like I pictured it in first grade.
So, how of all the voices that you've done, what is your? Do you have a favorite at all? Can you pick a favorite?
I get that a lot. Pooh and Tigger are kind of in their own category. You know, they're kind of like the classics, and so, you know, they're like I said, they're there. But then Darkwing Duck, the terror that collects in the night. We gotta love him, and these two kids, man. But that's okay, I'll recover. And, you know, I gotta tell you, so close to my heart, Ray from Princess and the Frog. You know, the women love a man with a big back coat. You know that, right? And then lately, it's Hondo Onaka. So it was very nice. He was written into, I think, a three-story arc in Clone Wars, on TV's Clone Wars. And for one reason or another, I never really said what they wrote. And they said, well, let's hire him back. The writers like me. I would do one as is, as written. And then I would Tourette out something else. You know? And they kind of took a liking to him. So he came back for Star Wars Rebels. And a funny story about that is the guys who were, you know, at Disney Character Voices called me in to talk about Hondo. And I thought, okay, let's do that. Sure, why not? I mean, I'm not doing anything. And they walked me into this big room, and they have these big giant storyboards, bigger than the panels on the wall. And there's pictures of Hondo doing this and Hondo doing that. Now he's on the Millennium Falcon. And I go, what's he doing on the Millennium Falcon? Stealing it. Oh, okay, sure. And I realized they were like pitching me on this idea. And I go, what are you, I don't understand if this is halfway, are you thinking of ever doing this? He goes, oh, it's halfway done. And I go, what is this going to be? And it's Millennium Falcon Smuggler's Run. If you get to Disney World or Disneyland, that's it. And I get to steal the Millennium Falcon about 1,000 times a day. So, I'll give you a ride if you want to, if you're in the neighborhood.
Did you ever get to ride that?
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, they brought me over to ride the prototype, and it just looks like this big, you know, I mean, like, I don't know, I guess you could fit it in this room, but it's huge. And they have 15 of these going at all times, and they just kind of rotate, because it only looks like when you're sitting outside, it just looks like there's the Millennium Falcon, there's the cockpit, you go and you sit, and it's total Star Wars. Looks just like, I mean, you're where Han and Luke was and everybody. And you sit down and there's like six people that ride each one of them, at a time. And one guy's steering left and right, one guy's going up and down, one guy's doing the speeds, two guys are shooting. And you have to work in coordination. They go, would you like to ride it? And I go, sure. So I was the pilot, which was a mistake. and so I get up there, and the first thing I do is go, and I'm like almost upside down, and I go, okay, this is real gravity. I'm going to die in here. I really better learn how to play it. So if you get a chance, definitely take a few practice runs. Cut in line, I don't know. But it's pretty cool. It's a lot of fun.
So we are going to have the opportunity for people to ask questions for Jim, and it's going to be over here on the side. So if anyone wants to ask their question, you're welcome to go over here and line up.
Yes.
While people are walking over there, and you're welcome to
go
do that.
Go right ahead.
And while we're doing that, we'll talk to Jim a little bit.
Oh, this
people are getting out and going over there. Jim, do you have anything, besides taking out house, in the house or through the house, do you have anything else that you're working on? I know that Darkwing Duck is coming in and out with some, and Negaduck. Well, see, I like the OG Duck.
Myself.
So do you like playing the villain better or, you know, the Darkwing?
Yes. I do. I like them both. You know, I get plenty of bad guys and plenty of good guys, and Hondo's like a little of both. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, bad guys have more fun. Captain Hook probably had a little more fun than Peter Pan. I don't know, maybe. But you know, as long as I'm in the show, I like playing the guy with the most lines. So that is a heavy determinant there. Oh, now when you come up to ask a question, you have to say your name and your favorite dessert. You didn't know there'd be a tough quiz involved here today, but that's the rule. So it looks like, why, yes, sir. What is your name and favorite dessert?
Hi. My name is Joe, and I guess my favorite dessert is brownies.
Oh, I'm sorry, that's wrong. Okay, so brownies, you gotta love that. Maybe with some vanilla ice cream scoop on top?
You bet. Maybe add a little cherry on top?
Nah. But that's just me. So what's happening, brother?
Well, I've got a question and something I'd like to say to you.
Oh. All right. Okay. It has to be a question you'd ask in front of your mother.
Fair enough.
Okay. You never know, you know what I mean?
Don't know if my mother would understand these references, but
uh-oh.
If Darkwing Duck and Don Karnazes were to meet, what would they probably say to each other?
You're in the wrong series, pal.
Probably. I don't know, it would be tough. Don Carnage. When you say Don Carnage, you have to roll the R. Like that. I think they would say something like that. Why, what do you think that they would say, or should say?
Honestly, I think they'd have choice words for each other. They're getting a good battle going on.
That could be, yeah. It wouldn't be pretty. And I would get a headache. But I would win. Either way, I would win. Of course, I'd always lose. I'd also lose. Anyway, thanks for bringing it up. Thanks, buddy.
And before I...
But there's more.
I just want to say, there was a time in my childhood when friends were hard to come by, so watching the new Adventures of Winnie the Pooh, I never felt alone. You guys were my friends, so just thanks for being there.
Thank you. Thanks for telling me that. And don't forget, when the going gets tough, the tough just bone. There you go. All right. Good man. Thank you, buddy. Yes, sir.
Hey, my name's Nick. Mm-hmm. My favorite dessert, cheesecake.
Oh, yeah.
Any kind of cheesecake.
Oh, tastes like cheesecake.
I have just a simple question for you. Do you prefer Hondo in Clone Wars or Rebels?
Oh boy. Yes. both. Yeah, hard to say. I think he was more of a, closer to being a pirate in Clone Wars, don't you think?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, for sure. Because everybody was kind of like scared of him. I remember, a month or two ago, I just saw it on Disney Plus, and I clicked on the show, and it was, the show was half over, and the first line was, Hondo Onaka won't kill us! Oh, man. So he used to be a little tougher.
He is.
I think in Clone Wars, he was a little more ruthless. But he kind of lost his empire. And don't you hate it when you lose your empire? You know what I mean? Jeez, there's nothing worse.
Really, don't miss you.
I'd rather lose an empire than to never have had one at all. You know? I'm waxing poetic here.
But, yeah,
thank you. Come on down.
Hi, I'm Gwen, and I'm a huge sweets person, so it's hard to pick anything with frosting, really.
Oh, okay. Now, who are you cosplaying? Are you cosplaying?
Yeah, I'm imagining a
I just realized she might not have been. That would have been terrible.
Okay.
From where?
A vampire anime.
Anime?
Yeah.
I don't do those, so I don't care. I'm kidding. You're adorable. I'm kidding. That's nice. Thanks.
So there is a very minuscule line that Tigger says in the Super Sleuth. Do you remember that?
Oh yes, I remember that.
And it's something that my family says all the time. It's very minuscule. And I was wondering if I said it, do you think you could say it?
What is it?
It's, and Tigger goes, bet you it's the hole. Or we're thinking for a mailbox or something, I don't know.
Did she say what I think she said?
Yeah.
Is that again? And give me the line again.
Bet you it's the hole.
You want me to say it now?
Yeah.
Can I just say it later?
Sure.
When everyone's around?
Sure.
Okay. Can you give me any context at all?
Yes, Piglet lost his mailbox, and so they were trying to find the hole where it was in the ground.
Oh, bet you it's the hole.
That was close. See, without context, I'm doomed. You know, Walt Disney's ghost would come up. You know, nobody wants that.
Sorry,
babe. All right, well, thank you very much. Good question, almost. Thank you. Thank you. And good hair.
Hi.
Hey, come on down.
My name is Sean, and my favorite dessert is a pecan pie cheesecake I got at a truck stop in Alabama.
Oh, it's that was you? that was...
The base is pecan pie, and it's topped with cheesecake and drizzled with caramel. I dream of this, and it scares me.
That's really good. See, I would have that, and my heart would just stop.
I was 19, so I was lucky.
Yeah, I would die a happy death. So what's happened?
I wanted to ask. A lot of voice actors, I feel they get to a point where when you hear their voice, it's more about the actor than it is the character. So what would the process be behind figuring out what the voice of a character, how do you approach how you voice a character with their inflections and speech patterns as opposed to just doing the same thing repetitively?
Well, it depends on how much money they have. it's like this. When, Winnie the Pooh and Tigger, they were around, when I was in grade school first, so that wasn't me. And they took, 30 years off, which was really good because it gave me a chance to grow up and then be them. Because I've been doing Pooh and Tigger since the 80s, mid-80s, 86, 87. And so, if it's an established character, the trick is you have to sound just like that character, because everybody knows it already. But on a new one, like Darkwing or Hondo Onaka, you know, I just kind of look at them, and, you know, Darkwing's not a super big guy, but he's not a teeny little guy. So you kind of put him somewhere in the middle, and they were worried that somebody was going to come up with a Darkwing that sounded like Daffy Duck, which was stupid, because he was a Warner Brothers character. But, something to just make it unique. And with Darkwing, I just used his ego. He's just got a super big ego. He thinks he's it, you know, and he's not necessarily it all the time. He gets his butt kicked a lot, you know. But, and you kind of incorporate all that together. And then with... another big one would be Hondo Onaka. And what I've done before in the past is I've mixed up, like, I have a philosophy. I'll just bore you with this for a minute here. If you do a perfect impression of somebody that nobody knows, it's a new character. And if you, like my Uncle Sam was, the first tug, I used to be a deckhand on a riverboat when I was a kid in New Orleans. And my first tugboat captain's name was Léonce Leblanc. And he was from New Orleans. He was from Napoleonville in Louisiana. And Leatherhead was supposed to be a Cajun alligator. Well, this guy was a Cajun alligator.
And he talked like this. He said, "Boy, I'm gonna tell you one time. You get out there, you go out to the boat back and you get over there and put on that other side like that."
And I went, I have no idea what he said. And so I incorporated that, and it sounds just like him, if I dare say so myself. In fact, I always said, you know, a couple of years later, after I was a deckhand, I was in California, and I got one of my first jobs was that. And I would give 10 cents to know if his grandkids are sitting around going, "Hey, Grandpa, come in here. You see this alligator? You know this guy?" Because it sounded just like him. And so, and my Uncle Sam,
he's another guy who talks like this.
But he had an Ohio accent, and he's been in a lot of cartoons. So if you do a perfect impression of somebody nobody knows, it's a new character. But like I say, with Hondo, Hondo Ohnaka, you guys know him, yeah?
No. Oh, yes.
He's a combination of two famous actors, and you'd never guess them. It's Charles Bronson and Yul Brynner. They're both passed on.
Oh. In Hondo, he sort of sounds like this, you see. And nobody says, everybody goes, "Where the hell is that guy from?" I go, "Never mind. Don't hurt you. You think you'll hurt yourself. Don't worry about it." So I just blend them together. And that's another trick to coming up with the sound of a character. And Jess Arnell has a great line. He says, when it comes to being a voice actor, it's a small V and a capital A. Because, you know, you have to kind of believe you are, you know, the various lunatics that I've played, you know, and it helps, you know, so it's an acting gig.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. And there's my buddies.
Yay!
How are you guys doing today?
We're good. We're good.
Oh, okay. I can see one of your mouths moving. Is that okay? yeah, him, definitely. And what's his name?
Zachary.
And what is your name?
Bryson.
That's right. His name is the street I was raised on, yeah. Bryson Street. Now, if your last name was Street, that would be killer. But what is your favorite dessert?
Oreo cakesters.
I wasn't talking to you. I'm just kidding. What's his favorite dessert? Very cool. So have you got a question, Bryson? Or comment or anything.
What do you think of Winnie the Pooh, Blood and Honey?
Winnie the Pooh,
Blood and Honey.
See, I can't even say that. I know what you're talking about. And it's I can't wait to not go and see that. just don't do it. Just because somebody sent a picture to me from the interwebs and no, just don't. It's like, you know. Taking a tour of an outhouse, if you ask me. No, just don't do it. And that's all I think.
Seems like an interesting mood for me to see. I'll see you later.
Okay, pal. Thank you. Hey, come on down.
Hi there. My name's Brandon, and I'm going to choose Kit Kat as my favorite dessert.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah. My question for you, you somewhat famously sang part of Be Prepared in The Lion King. Mm-hmm. Were you already like on that project before Jeremy Irons lost his voice, or did they just call you up and say, "Jim, we got a problem, we need you to help us out"?
He didn't lose his voice.
I was. I mean, I was in there. I was Ed, the good-looking hyena. So I had that going for me. But, and Jess Harnell and I, y'all know Jess, right? Animaniac, great, great guy, amazing singer. They knew I sang and they knew Jess sang. And Ernie Sabella and Nathan Lane, who were Pumbaa and Timon in the movie, they weren't singers, you know. So they said, well, let's just get Jim and Jess to sing it. And then, you know, we'll give them a cassette to ride around in and play it in their car. You know, and that way you kind of know it, like for a month or whatever, until you know it. And that way you know it so well, it's like, you know, happy birthday. You know, it's in your head. And so we did that, and at first the lyrics were all like, when I was a kid it was rough, you had it easy, I had it tough, everything was good for you, everything was horrible for me. And it's like, man, everybody's parents tells them that, and it's boring all the time. My dad had to walk uphill in the snow both ways, home and back to school, you know, and I go, no, we don't want that. So I something hit me, and I said, well, wait, doesn't Timon have a problem with flatulence? And and so anyway, I made up the part verse. Thank you. Part verse right here. I class up everything I do. And then as far as be prepared, they, you know, like I say, they knew I sang and I'm a fairly decent mimic. And the line, which I'm not allowed to tell you, okay, I'll tell you, was Tim Rice, Elton wasn't there, my close personal friend, Elton John. Anyway, they said, you can have every bloody Marlboro the man has ever smoked. And I said, oh, okay. So I ended up singing Be Prepared. And what they did, you know, I sang the whole thing. He sang the whole thing, and I sang the whole thing. And then they just go like this. And he never says the words, be prepared. Every time you hear, be prepared, and you always laugh, by the way. The villain always laughs at the end of the song he sings. It's the law. You know, did you see Anastasia?
Yes.
I was a bad guy in that one too, Christopher Lloyd. Same, you know, you just laugh. Nothing's funny, but you're laughing. So there you have it.
Thank you very much.
Did I answer anything remotely close to your question?
Yeah, I just wanted to know more about that story.
Oh, wow. Okay, good. Thank you. All right. Well, there she is. She's trouble. You're friends with this one.
Yes. My best friend. I'm Taylor, and my favorite dessert, I mean, I don't know if it would be considered dessert, but boba tea.
What? Huh?
Boba tea.
What is that?
I don't know how to describe it, but like it has like little tapioca pearls in it. You can get like chocolate, or you can get it matcha.
Do you buy this from people on street corners and dark alleys?
There's specific places for it.
She's not going anywhere. Okay, so what's your question, Kim?
So if you were to choose a Pooh character, which one would you say is more like your personality?
Wait, one of my characters, you mean? I don't know, maybe Darkwing and Tigger. And Hondo. And Ray. And Skeletor. Oh wait, that's not me. I don't know. I guess a little of all of them. Yeah. Which one is most like yours?
I would probably have to say sometimes Eeyore, because I can get, well, not your character.
Oh,
but
fine.
Like
I don't
character.
Do Eeyore.
I would
thanks
be like two characters.
Noticing.
Like, I mean, if I were to choose like one of your characters, I'd probably say like Pooh, because you know, I feel like I kind of have a personality like Pooh in real life.
It's probably the fangs. Well, that's great. Thank you. All right. And yes, little girl. And what is your name?
My name's Margaret.
And what is your last name?
I'm Margaret Cummings.
Yeah, oh, okay.
That's my wife. Instead of me.
Yes, I am lucky. Thank you.
Instead of me telling you my favorite dessert, I think you should tell everyone what my favorite dessert is.
She does this all the time. Lemon meringue pie. And me.
Well, usually you just say lemon, you forget the meringue pie.
Oh.
Okay, so what I thought we could do, did anyone here go to Dragon Con? Okay, so if you heard the answers, you're not allowed to say it. But oh. Jim and I did a TikTok where I had to try and guess some 600 characters of Jim's. And he was offended that I didn't know all of them. And so we put it on TikTok, and to this day, no one has gotten all of them right. And I'm not going to do 600, but we'll do 10, I think. And the first person who guesses them all can head on over to the table after so don't announce it here, and you can get a free autograph with a picture from Jim. So we'll put a challenge out there.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to ask Jim, and he's going to answer, but he might be tricking you. So it might be yes or no. So if you want, you could write it down, or you could video him, but I'll give you 10. Can you count so I know when I'm at 10? Okay, so here's some questions. Jim, were you in Bay Pig in the City?
I think there were, yes.
Okay. And you guys, not all of this is Googleable, so you can't...
Yeah, that's right. One or two.
Were you...
No.
Were you in Married with Children?
No.
Were you in...
Bing, bing, one, two, hello, can you hear me?
Yes. No. See, we can't hear him. That's so funny that I said no. What have you got, sir?
Okay, my name is Matthew Wallace. My favorite dessert is vanilla ice cream.
Okay.
Send me with the caramel and you got yourself a deal.
What?
Tempt me with the caramel on top of that ice cream and you got yourself a deal.
Muy bien. I'm soaking in it. Okay. And do you have a question?
Oh, yes. What is the first in family voice actor? I'm trying to remember that word. Oh, yeah. What was the first event movie you voice acted or acted in, and what was it like?
Well, it was Who Framed Roger Rabbit.
Ah.
And I think I had three lines. I was a weasel. I know. I guessed. But I was a weasel, but I ended in a bullet. And they cut out the scene with the weasel. And we were there like in Griffith Park all night long. And they just didn't use it, but that happens. But I am in the, when Eddie Valiant goes and he's got his tune gun that he takes from Yosemite Sam, I was bullet number two. But that was my first claim to fame. And I get to buy a poster for it and everything. You know? But that was it, that was my first one. Thank you. All right, anything else?
What was it like acting like Darkwing Duck?
Oh, it was like awesome, actually. I mean, he's one of my favorite guys, one of my personal favorites. So I'm glad everybody likes him. Thanks.
Stay dangerous, bro. Watch out, or you'll be the new launch pad.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Do you think Darkwing will ever get his own series again?
Well, I think you should. Don't you? I think y'all should write some letters. I'm tired of writing them.
He keeps guest starring, but he definitely needs.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Well, boy, I'll tell you. A lot of people are asking me that, like all the time. Mm-hmm. And we're not waiting on me. I'll be there.
So the address is Disney. Yeah,
Buena Vista.
Yeah, right.
Street somewhere.
So, Jim, tell us how you got your start in voice acting, and how did that come about? Someone in this audience would love to know how
sure.
You did.
Well, the very first job I ever had was it was Dumbo Circus. I don't even think they didn't save many of them. It was Disney Channel had just started up, and 85 or 86, something like that. And I was Lionel, and it was basically Dumbo. But it was people in costumes, you know, some little people, some, you know, regular folks and what have you. And, you know, they couldn't have like a 4-foot mouse because he was Timothy, basically. Lionel was Timothy from Dumbo.
And so I did sort of a little bitty guy like that.
And he was from Chicago, sort of sounding. And he was Lionel. And so that was my very, very first job. It was for Disney. So that's kind of cool. And somewhere along the line, because I don't know what happened, but we made 65 of those, and I think only like 12 of them are still out there. I don't know why.